This episode of The Couch is proudly supported by Cafe Bella Vista Restaurant and Pizzeria. Azito, give it a go with Azito. Refresh Pure Water. And Reading Cinemas, experience the difference.
Hello Australia, welcome to another Big Couch, episode 487 to be exact. Check out who's on the show today. On the show today, we've got Dr. Jenny talking brain smart. Later on the show, we look at all the latest new movies thanks to Sony Pictures Australia with Kathy Sharp, and talk about Sharp gardening with our very fairy Cara. And later on, we talk about the Sunflower Dash that's coming up very soon thanks to Leukaemia Foundation. We'll talk to them as well. Very big show. Episode 487 starts now.
It's showtime on the couch. Yeah, it's showtime on the couch. You can see it from your house. You can watch it from your house. It's showtime on the couch. With Fred and the best in town. Oh, it's showtime on the couch.
It does remind me, I need to speak to our director about getting rid of that horrible swimsuit thing that I wear. Looks quite embarrassing. Anyway, big show today. Olivia Newton-John is a fantastic Australian actress. She's also a fantastic singer. She's not with us today, but Alix Jordan and the team are here. They're putting together a fantastic tribute show. Now, if you want more information about the tribute show, maybe how you can get involved or where the shows are going to be, please check out Alix Jordan's website. But for today, they're opening with a beautiful Olivia Newton-John song called Have You Never Been Mellow? Here they are.
Just to hear a song.
That is, of course, Alix Jordan and the team from the new tribute show that's just coming all around New Zealand, Australia, and maybe the world very, very soon. So if you want more information, please check out Alix Jordan's website, because I know she's looking for some support, because it's very expensive to put on a play and a show. So Alix Jordan, now they're going to be performing again. I've just asked, yep. That she's confirming. So they're going to perform another two numbers later on today, so please stay tuned for that one. Someone that's not doing a number on us is Charles Otway. He's a fantastic gardener, and with him is our very own fairy in the garden, Cara Walker. Over to you.
Thank you, Fred. And today we welcome Charles back to the couch for our new Talking Gardening. Welcome to the couch.
Thanks, Cara.
Now, Charles is an expert. He comes from Terra Perma, and we're really excited today to talk about something interesting. What have we got here?
We've got an idea we're going to talk about called wicking beds.
Wicking beds, okay.
And this is a wicking barrel, because it's a barrel cut in half.
Okay, yeah. And so what's a wicking bed?
So a wicking bed, the idea is you're holding a reservoir of water underneath the soil and it comes up through capillary action. It's not really anything new, because we've been using self-watering pots for a long time.
Okay.
But this is kind of a self-watering pot you can make yourself.
Okay, great. And I'm guessing that these are pretty cheap to make as well?
Yeah, these are pretty cheap to get. This is half of an olive barrel, so if you've got a double olive barrel there, it's twice as big. Yep. Cut it in half with a saw.
Great, okay.
And about $15 for an olive barrel.
Yeah, and then you can make it yourself. Okay, so if we've got a barrel like this, how can we go about making it? What do we do?
So we're cutting it in half, so there's another half there, so that gets you two pots.
Sure, okay.
So about $7.50 for a 100-litre pot.
That's awesome.
It's really cheap.
If you go pot shopping, then you know that's a great deal.
Yep, and we're looking to create a reservoir in the bottom of this.
Okay.
It's nice and sealed. It's pretty easy to do.
Yep.
Some of the wicking beds, they use black plastic and things to create a reservoir underneath.
Yep.
But that's a little bit tricky, whereas if we use something that's a container
and
we put a hole in the side here.
Okay.
So there's a hole down there for drainage.
Yep.
And we want to make that hole about the height of these pots.
Okay, yep.
Now, in a self-watering pot, there's a reservoir in there.
Yeah.
In this thing, the upside-down pot plant creates the reservoir.
Ah, interesting.
So that's where the water sits.
Yeah.
And then as the water gets sucked up into the soil, air comes in to replace it.
Ah, aerating.
And then until we water it again, so that's our reservoir happening there.
Okay, that's really, really clever. Do it yourself. And these are all just recycled pots that you put upside down into the bottom.
Yeah, any old pots will be fine, but we want something about 1.5 litres as a pot, so we get a decent size reservoir.
Yeah,
we're looking for about sort of 20 litres
and
maybe 60 to 80 litres of soil on top.
Okay, and then what do we do from here? We've got our...
So if we went to making it, we cut our barrel in half, we could just use a handsaw for that. That's pretty safe, pretty simple once you get the first cut. Then we're looking to measure the height of the drill hole. So any hole drill will work to make that hole. Don't make a huge one, because if you make a huge one, you can't make it any smaller later.
Okay, yep.
So that's where the water escapes, so that the soil above doesn't get waterlogged. So it's important to have that drain.
Yep, and that's bad for your plants, isn't it?
Yeah, you don't want waterlogged soil, otherwise the roots will rot.
Awesome, okay.
So we're getting these pots, and we're popping them in the bottom of this barrel to create our reservoir.
Yep.
And then we're using some mulch, just street tree mulch, wood chips, something like that.
Yep.
And we're going to pop it around these pots to stabilise the pots.
Okay.
So we can do that on... We can do that. Just get into it.
Awesome.
I probably don't have enough there, but I think we'll get the idea.
Smells earthy. Does this come from your front verge?
It does. It comes from my driveway, actually. I've got my whole driveway mulched.
Awesome.
So if in a real thing, we'd be trying to get that mulch level with the pot the whole way around.
Okay, yep.
Yeah.
And that holds all the all these in place. And I'm guessing they're really good for the water as well.
Yeah, they're good. And that, obviously the mulch is pretty rough and there's a fair bit of water space inside the mulch.
Sure, yep.
So we could have blue metal or bitumen, bitumen, or gravel or something like that in there as well, but it would make the pot a lot heavier.
A lot heavier for the old moving days. Okay, and then what do we do the next layer from here?
So it's pretty simple. It's put the pots in, put the mulch on top, and then it's really a good quality soil mix or something like that on top.
And would it be a potting mix that you would go for?
I don't tend to go for potting mixes, but you could.
Yeah.
You wouldn't go for a straight compost.
Okay.
That's a bit too rich.
Yeah. Okay.
But like this is a vegetable mix, so it's got sand and all the other stuff in it as well.
Okay.
Potting mixes tend to have a lot more mulch and things like that.
Okay.
So we really don't need that. We need some soil to grow the veggies in.
Okay, awesome. All right, and then so we'd pop this on top. Did you want to do that one?
Yeah, we can put that in.
Let's do it.
Woohoo! So we're tipping that in there. It's going straight on top.
Yep.
Some of the wicking beds, they talk about putting a layer of geotextile between the wicking area and the soil so the soil doesn't silt down.
Geotech, what's that?
Oh, it's a layer to stop, it's like a layer of knitted fabric to stop the soil going down into the reservoir and filling up the pots.
Ah, okay, sure. Yep.
But I've made a number of these and they're 6 months old or so and the soil hasn't silted out into the pots.
Okay.
So they work fine without it. It's just a waste of money, really.
Okay, sure. All right, and then what kind of things could you plant in a pot like this?
Well, it's an 80-litre pot, so it's a very big pot.
Yep.
So you can consider it almost a garden bed.
Sure. Okay.
In summer, these are really good because you've got 20 litres of water underneath, so you can get about a week of not watering.
Good.
So if you're hand watering,
so
you can go away for
gardener,
the weekend.
That's what we want to hear.
That's it.
Yeah.
Definitely. Obviously, we would fill this soil up to the edge if we had the extra soil.
Yep, okay.
And you could plant anything in there, anything from kale to lettuce to broccoli. Herbs.
Yep.
I've got some curry trees and other things in there.
Okay. So what's a good couple of things do you think to throw in there this time of year?
Well, being winter, we're looking at winter crops. So brassicas, so broccoli, kale, cabbage.
Yep.
You might want to throw in some of those companions. So borage, dandelions. I've got a lot of dandelions growing really well now.
Okay. Yeah. And that's going to keep off the pests and...
It'll both feed the predators.
Okay.
And some of the things, if you put some nasturtium in there and the nasturtium could cascade down the side.
It's always pretty.
And that would distract the pests as well.
Okay, great. And then where could people find a barrel like this if we wanted to make a cheap to free wicking barrel?
Well, these are ex-olive barrels.
Okay.
So they come in with imported olives.
Yep.
So if you look at salvage places and things like that,
that's
where you should find them.
Okay, great.
Look online, eBay, Gumtree type thing, those kind of searches.
Awesome, okay. And so where could they go to find you, Charles, and get some more information?
Well, I work out of a place called Terra Perma, so www.terraperma.com.au.
Okay.
And there's a two-page manual on exactly how to build these.
Fantastic.
So what we've talked about and more.
Okay. That's all the info there.
And if people have questions, they're always welcome to email me.
Okay, great. All right, thank you so much for coming on and explaining that. That was wonderful. We've heard from Charles today, and he's actually going to be coming back next month with our new Talking Gardening on the Couch. So look out for these fantastic segments. If you'd like more information, head to the Couch website, thecouch.com.au. We'll have a link directly to Terra Perma and the information page on where you can get this wicking barrel. All right, thanks.
All right,
back to you, Fred.
Oh, Cara, you're looking so good playing around the dirt, putting your hands in that dirt. Oh, I know you like it. And Charles Otway, thank you very much. He'll be back very, very soon on the couch. We'll need to take a break because coming up after the break, we've got another one of Olivia Newton-John's favourite songs. Stay tuned.
This episode of The Couch is proudly supported by Cafe Bella Vista Restaurant and Pizzeria. Azito, give it a go with Azito. Refresh Pure Water. And Reading Cinemas, experience the difference.
Welcome back to The Couch here on Aurora Television and Face TV. And don't forget to tell all your friends that if they don't have Foxtel or Face TV, they can now watch us online on thecouch.com.au every Sunday night at around about 7 o'clock Perth time, which is, 8 o'clock Perth time, which is 10 o'clock over East. I think I got that right. Thecouch.com.au. Now, I was telling you at the beginning of the show, Alix Jordan is putting together a fantastic Olivia Newton-John tribute show. Now they're back to perform for us, the group, and it's a fantastic song. It's called Let Me Be There in Your Morning. Well, you won't need her to perform. I could just do it myself. No, here she is, Alix Jordan and the group doing Let Me Be There.
Surely you know I always want to be there, holding your hand and standing by.
is let me be there.
Watching it grow and going through the changes in your life, that's how I know I always want to be there. Whenever you feel you need a friend to lean on, here I am. Whenever you call, you know I'll be there. Let me
Time now to make our brains a little bit smarter, or a lot smarter, with Dr. Jenny Brockis' help. Welcome back to the couch.
Thanks very much, Fred.
It is nice to have you back. It seems too long.
It has been a while, hasn't it?
And you've been away writing a book as well.
I have,
traveling.
Yes.
Now, I've
yes.
got the book here on set. It's called Brain Smart. Mm. Tell us the first book you wrote, Jenny. That was called Brain Fit. What was mm-hmm. that one about?
Brain Fitness was the book all about sort of how to make sure that you're doing those things that you know make a difference to how well you operate, mm-hmm. sort of looking after yourself, the way you eat, how you do your exercise and stuff like that. Brain Smart I wrote because so many people are so busy and so distracted, they can't pay attention to things anymore very easily and they get frustrated.
What causes that? Is it just being busy?
It's just being over busy. We're all getting too busy. We've got too much to do.
We were
too
just
little
saying
time.
That this morning, haven't yeah. we? We're all flat out.
And it's causing people stress. Mm. And of course, the more stress we get, then it makes it even harder to know how to pay attention to stuff.
So when you say people need to become brain smart, how do we become brain smart?
Well, it's about how to understand how your brain actually operates when it comes down to what you do to pay attention. And then it's just going through some fairly simple exercises, because you can train your brain to change your mind. Which is
really?
Pretty cool. Yeah, you can do
okay.
that.
So do we all need this sort of help? I mean, is it for younger people? Is it for middle age, or just across the board?
It's across the board, because it really sort of reflects, if you think that you're getting into a bit of trouble because you can't pay attention to what you want to pay attention to and it's affecting your stress levels, then this is a book for you.
Do we know the common causes that cause this?
There are multiple causes.
What type of things can people be going through that could be saying, maybe that book can help me? Give me some examples.
Okay, it's not always external things, relationships obviously, but social media plays a big part in
this. That's been very big. Everybody's on social media now.
Everybody's on it. We love it.
And there's a lot of talk now that we did a story a couple of weeks ago about a thing on the net called Look Up.
Yes.
Meaning, have you seen that? It's amazing.
It's fantastic. I recommend everybody should watch that.
It's called Look Up on YouTube if you haven't already seen it. But it's all about the society we live in now, and not so much for me because I don't do Facebook or Twitter apart from the show, but kids today from the age of about 10 are on Facebook.
Oh, they're excuse me, 3 and 4-year-olds are on social media.
Isn't it amazing? From a doctor's point of view,
yes.
is there a harm that people are causing themselves for spending so much time on social
There's
media?
There's a potential harm, and that's the issue. I mean, our technology is wonderful. Social media is a boon. We can connect with people so easily.
But too easily,
But I think. Sometimes it's too easily, and sometimes the technology takes us over rather than us being in control, and that's when we get into a bit of difficulty.
And how do we overcome these problems? Like, I know reading the book's one part might be able to help, but this is probably the first step.
First step, it,
because
yeah.
a lot of people don't like to admit that they've got a problem and that they need help.
Yes.
And I think I love the fact that you call it brain smart, and it's not a technical term. No. It's something that will keep people thinking simple, and maybe they'll, you know, the book's not very thick.
No, it's quite it's a short book, and it's been written to be sort of quite straightforward, just to sort of understand what you could be doing to get a different outcome. So you can reduce your stress levels, regain your focus, and find you can get more done and just feel better about everything.
And a smarter brain, obviously.
And a smarter brain to boot, so
that's
a bonus as well.
That's where you want to be, a smarter brain, a fitter brain leads you to having a better life as
Absolutely
well.
Absolutely, it does.
So with the book itself, you've written, how long did it take you to write?
This one was about 6 months.
6 months, that's not bad.
So that's not bad.
Next one's out soon?
Well, probably August, September.
Do you know what the next one's going to be about?
It's going to be called Future Brain.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, do you like that?
I like it. What does that mean? What does the topic...
This one is about how to design our brain for the future. What do we need for ourselves
in
order to work better?
So are you looking at the struggles that may come up in the future and how we deal with
them? Yeah, because we've got so much change going on in our lives.
So recap again, this book, Brain Smart, is out now.
It's out now.
Where can people get it?
You can get it in two places. You can get it at Amazon.com. Mm-hmm. Or you can go to my website, which is www.drjennybrockis.com, and it's doctor with just a little dr.
Just a little dr.
Too much
people. Yeah. You're an informative person. You're very helpful. I love the fact you bring things down to basics, because that's what it's all about. It's about people actually wanting to get help. Mm. And I think sometimes if it becomes too complicated, people tend to denial. They work in denial. And I think this will help so many people. Just quickly recap again the type of people that may benefit from reading the book.
Anybody who's feeling a bit overwhelmed, a bit frustrated, a bit stressed out from just having too much to do.
I thought you were going to say overweight.
No.
Overwhelmed.
Overwhelmed, yeah.
And overwhelmed, like we've said, it could be because of too much work, too much stress, relationship issues.
All those
anything
things.
At all that you're not quite sure what the problem is and you haven't spoken to your doctor, get the book. It's a good read. It's only how many pages? Do you know?
It's about 164 pages.
Let me test you. It's about 96 pages.
It's a short book.
But do you realise I've just made her brain smart? No, 96 pages. The next one's probably 164. But you know what? That's what I love about your books. People write catalogues.
Yeah.
And nobody wants to read catalogues. No. This is a very simple book. You can read it while you're in the plane. You can read it while you're at work and your lunch break. A little bit at night maybe while you're watching TV or not watching TV. Mm. Jenny, thank you very much. Do we know a price for how much the book is?
It's $24.99.
$24.99. Mm-hmm. You can get it from Amazon.com or you can check out Dr. Jenny's website. But don't forget, you can also check out our website, thecouch.com.au, and all the details will be there for Dr. Jenny. Thank you very much for coming in and spending some time with us.
Delighted to
see you. We look forward to being future brain smart.
Yes, indeed.
Is that what we're calling it?
Just future brain.
Future brain. Future I'll get brain. That right by next time you come in. Thank you very much, Dr. Jenny.
Great. Thank
nice
you so
having
much,
you here.
Friend.
And if you'd like to have more information about where you can find out more about The Couch, check this out.
If you're looking for more info on anything you've seen on today's show, head to thecouch.com.au. It's where you'll find all the links for our guests, plus clips from the show, backstage photos, and even exclusive movie reviews. You can also sign up as a Couchie and be part of our competitions, including Spin It to Win It. New Zealand viewers, that's open to you too. So jump online and check it out now. thecouch.com.au. This episode of The Couch is proudly supported by Cafe Bella Vista Restaurant and Pizzeria. Azito, give it a go with Azito. Refresh Pure Water. And Reading Cinemas, experience the difference.
Welcome back to The Couch here on Aurora Television and Face TV around Australia. We've got a fantastic event coming up very soon. It's called the Sunflower Dash. To talk about more about this event is our very own Sunflower, Ray of Sunshine, Lauren.
Thank you, Fred. And here today on The Couch we have Andrew York with us, a big Ray of Sunshine himself. Thanks for being on The Couch, Andrew.
Thanks, Lauren.
Now we're all warm and sunny on the inside, actually. We're here to talk about the Sunflower Dash. So first of all, for our viewers, tell us a little bit about the Leukaemia Foundation.
I'm Lauren. The Leukaemia Foundation provides a range of basic support services to people with a blood cancer. And that comes in two formats. We provide accommodation for rural people that might be diagnosed We have an education program as well, and we also raise funds for research because that's important in the way to find a cure for the future. Mm. The story behind the Leukaemia Foundation is there's roughly 50,000 people each year living with a blood cancer in Australia, and that equates to 11,500 people each year that are diagnosed. One of the sad facts today is over the next 2 hours, someone with a blood cancer will pass away.
Oh. And so there's some great work, though, that the Leukaemia Foundation does supporting those people. So really great. And then tell us a little bit more about all this fun here. What is the Sunflower Dash?
The Sunflower Dash is really a short fun run, but what we ask people to do is unleash your inner child and have some fun and dress up. So you can do the run. You have to dress up in a onesie or a pair of happy pants or like Lauren with a sunflower in your hair. And it's just a short run up to 5 kilometres. There's a shorter run for younger people as well, which is 500 metres. So it's really just a dash rather than a longer run.
Great, great. And then there's also an option to do a dare, the dash or the dare. So for maybe people who aren't near Perth or near their central town, they can do something regionally. So tell us a little bit more.
That's
about
right.
That.
So if you're living in a regional area or you can't make one of the fun runs in one of the cities, all you simply do is go onto the website and look at some of the dares that you can do. So a dare could be as simply as wearing some sunflowers to work. We have a gentleman in Western Australia that's dressing up on a mine site and he's covering himself in sunflowers. Wow. It might be baking some sunflower cakes and taking them into work. So it's pretty diverse, pretty open to what you can do.
Yeah, and you can get pretty risky there.
You can do pretty risky things, yes.
Get people to fund you, the more risky it is.
Well, that's right. We don't necessarily endorse wearing your speedos and dashing through work with sunflowers on you.
Yeah.
A bit cold in winter.
Yeah.
But on a serious note, the symbolism of the sunflower is the sunflower follows the sun around on a cold day, and it also gives hope to people. So that's why we're using the sunflower. So even though it's symbolic, it just brightens up someone's day that has a blood cancer.
So how can people get involved?
The easiest way to get involved is to go to the website, which is sunflower-org.au, and just follow the prompts. So the prompts will take you through the links to the major cities, gives you hints around fundraising, and gives you the information you need to know about where the events are.
Okay, fantastic. Well, thank you so much for being on the couch, Andrew, and all the best. Sounds like so much fun. I wish I could be involved.
Yep.
So that's next Sunday, the Sunflower Dash, so get up online. If you've missed any of those details, you can go on to thecouch.com.au and now check out this promo.
Like a fantastic day. Thank you very much, Lauren. I'm looking forward to doing maybe the shorter distance walk. Kathy Sharp from Sony Pictures is here with me today. Are you going to do that yourself?
Oh, I just might do it, actually.
I don't know if I'll wear the speedos, but...
No, I'm not.
There's something about the speedos and the sunflower. There's nowhere to pin the...
sunflower.
Well, I need somewhere to pin the flower on. I don't think the speedos are going to do it for some reason. Kathy, welcome to the couch.
Thank you.
We're not talking about sunflowers today, but we're talking about your fantastic movies that Sony Pictures Australia have got.
A few movies coming up, yes.
Go for it. What have we got first?
First up for us on June 19 is 22 Jump Street, starring the original two.
Yes.
Channing Tatum and Jonah Hill. And what I love about this film is that it doesn't care that it's a sequel. It actually is making fun of that fact the whole way through.
I like the fact you've gone from 21 Jump Street to 22 Jump
yes.
Street. Next year we're hoping 23 Jump
well,
Street comes along.
You have to watch the credits in this film. If you go and see the film, make sure you stay for the credits because there's a nod to 23, 24, 20. It's
Kathy,
very funny.
Remakes sometimes don't work. You know, we remember the original in our days, the 21 Jump Street TV show.
Yeah.
And then the movie came out, we loved it. And now 22 Jump Street, I've seen a sneak preview.
Yeah.
It's fantastic. It looks just as funny as the previous.
It's actually funnier. I laugh so much more in this film. I think because it is setting itself up all the way through. And the friendship between Jonah and Channing comes through, and they actually are setting that up too in a whole bromance thing with innuendos all the way through the film. It's very funny.
Are there any cameos in this one, or are they all gone? Because I know Johnny Depp was in the last one, wasn't he?
Yeah. Richard Jekko? He makes a small appearance.
Okay.
From, of course, from the 21 Jump Street TV show.
Looks fantastic.
All those years ago. Yeah,
I look forward to seeing that. Let's check out the trailer. Here it is, 22 Jump Street.
Well, I hoped never to see you again.
What's up, dog?
We're back.
Hey, I got a big ass raise to babysit you two again.
You going back to high school?
No, you look like you're about 50. You're going to MC State.
Hot plate.
Beanbag chair.
Hilarious shirt that signals we drink alcohol.
I don't have a single lead.
We need an expert to consult.
I heard someone's bringing a ton of that stuff down to Mexico for spring break.
We don't know who it is. We don't know who it is.
That's you.
That doesn't sound anything like me.
It doesn't sound anything like me.
It's not you.
You gotta take your thing to the next level, guys.
Spring break, mother.
You're sleepy. What's up, homie?
Everyone saying the barrio. He like the Mexican Wolverine.
When he talking?
My name is Jeff.
We Jump Street, and we're about to jump in your ass.
Mm-hmm. Right in the crack.
White boy wasted. That's just a sneak preview. Looks very funny. When does that come out?
June 19.
Beautiful.
Yeah.
What else have we got?
Then following on from that, we have an exclusive release to certain cinemas across Australia in a film called Tim's Vermeer, which is a documentary. It's produced by Penn and Teller, the illusionists who are famous in Vegas, if you've ever been there. And you know?
Okay. No, but you can tell me about it.
They also had a little snippet here, also had a quick episode of The West Wing. Did you ever watch The West Wing?
Yes, I did.
I love The West Wing. And there was one episode where they were performing for the president's daughter in the White House, and they illusionally, if there is such a word, burnt the American flag, and the whole episode was around that.
Oh, wow.
Yeah. But anyway, that's a side story. Tim's Vermeer is about, it's a documentary about a engineer and inventor who wants to get to the bottom of the whole theory that Vermeer actually didn't freehand paint, but he was, his pictures came, or his artwork came to life by way of light and mirrors. And so he sets himself this task to actually reproduce a Vermeer. He's never painted anything in his life. Mm. And it is mesmerising. I'm not into art, I will say that up front, but there's a scene in the film where I just went, no way, how is that even possible? Out loud, screaming at the cinema screen. How is that possible? It really is amazing.
Check out the trailer.
Sometimes when I'm trying to get to sleep, all I can think about is trying to paint a Vermeer, who some consider the greatest painter of all time. At the face of it, that seems almost impossible, because I'm not a painter. I'm looking at this image and I see something that looks like it came out of a video camera. This fall off of light is something that an artist really cannot see. There must be a way to actually get the colors accurate with mechanical means. I propped up a small mirror at a 45 degree angle. Right on the forehead, you can see that they match.
Holy cow.
It took me about half an hour to learn how to operate a paintbrush.
Good for you, it took me 40 years.
It's possible that he was more of a tinkerer, more of a geek. And in that way, I feel a kinship with him.
So you're going to construct a replica of the exact room where Vermeer painted?
That's right. The harpsichord, the Spanish chair, the viola da gamba, the rug.
This is very ingenious.
That's where the painting is, Buckingham Palace.
Using Tim's device, you become a machine.
I'm proposing an alternate history of Vermeer.
Was Vermeer a machine?
Oh, my God.
I think it might disturb quite a lot of people.
Looks good.
Yeah, so Tim is Tim Jennison, his name is. He's, as I said, an inventor from the US. And the original Vermeer that he's trying to copy is actually, you've got a nod to that in the trailer, it's actually within the Queen's Art Gallery in Buckingham Palace.
Fantastic.
And he wants to go and have a look at it, but of course it's in Buckingham Palace. But he actually gets an audience with the Queen.
Looks like an amazing movie, documentary.
Yeah, it's a documentary if you like docos. It opens exclusively here in Perth at Cinema Paradiso, and across the country at select cinemas.
Sex tape.
From one to the other.
Mm-hmm.
Sex tape is Cameron Diaz and Jason Segel, who were together in Bad Teacher a few years back. It's a hilarious great story, actually, about a husband and wife whose private life, their sex life, has gone down the tube a bit, as it does when you've got kids running around and a million other things to do. And so they decide to spice up their life and make their own private sex tape on their iPad. But what they don't remember is that they gave iPads to all of their relatives and even her boss for Christmas, and it accidentally ends up in the cloud. So then they have to chase.
Not good.
They have to chase to erase. It's a tagline to the film. The chase to erase begins by trying to get all the iPads back and destroy them before anybody sees the tape.
And this would be a perfect movie for Cameron Diaz, because she's a fantastic
absolutely.
Role.
Coming off the back of The Other Woman. I love the fact that she's actually playing a role that is, you know, her age, if you like, in this film.
Fantastic. Yeah. It's called Sex Tape. Check it out.
Hello, and welcome to an evening with Annie and Jay.
Annie, erase that video.
I'll erase it, babe.
Don't forget, okay?
I won't forget.
You're really loud.
Yeah.
Erasing the video like you said that she would, our sex tape ended up sinking to all the iPads we gave out as gifts.
Technically, yes.
My mom.
Robbie.
My boss.
And the mailman.
The mailman.
It was Christmas. Who wants to have some fun? Hello? You gotta be kidding me. No, no, deal! Siri, how do you perform CPR on a dog?
There you go, Sex Tape.
So that's in cinemas July 17. And there's a little bit of a ironic part to this film in that Rob Lowe plays her boss. Of course, he's had his own dalliances with sex tape, so it's kind of funny in itself.
Yes, expert there, sex expert. Okay, the final one we're looking at today is one with Eric Banner in it.
Yes, our Australian Eric Banner gets a bit of a run in a thriller called Deliver Us From Evil. This is based on real-life events of a New York police sergeant, Sergeant Ralph Saatchi, and that is who Eric Banner plays. And it's a story of the police sergeant's dalliances, meetings with the occult in his daily beat. It's pretty scary, if you like a thriller.
I saw the trailer and we had to edit it. It was so scary.
Yeah, it's Eric Banner's fantastic in it. Olivia Munn plays opposite him as his wife, who, of course, is from... I've gone blank.
That's okay. You'll remember it after we show the trailer.
Yes.
But is this a remake or is this an original?
No, it's story? An original, yeah.
Okay, so we're maybe hoping a little series will come from this, maybe a new another
maybe.
One.
Maybe. Another I Saw. Know. I don't know.
It's different for Eric Banner. Has he played one of these sort of roles before?
I don't think he has.
No, I've never seen
him. I mean, we of course know him from Fast Forward and being the comedic actor in Australian movies and, you know, going on to do Roman Sandal things.
Yeah. And what was the one that I... Was it Romulus, My Father?
That was fantastic.
That was an awesome movie for him, Eric Banner. So I'm looking forward to seeing this. So let's check out the trailer.
Thank you.
This crazy lady's complaining about strange disturbances. What's this writing mean?
I've experienced two types of evil in this life. Secondary evil, the evil that men do, and primary evil, which is something else entirely. Every culture, every religion has practiced exorcism.
Something's happening to me.
You can sense what others can't, but it also puts you at risk. Your family is already in danger.
Mommy.
Let's begin.
Is This is going to be your favourite, isn't it, Kathy?
Oh, look, I'm not good with scary films, but the fact that it's based on real-life events scares the bejeebus out of me, but that's
it's okay. The type of movie you hope is going to be very, very good, because you wouldn't want to be stuck in the cinema on your own to watch that.
No.
And I reckon you've got a bit of a winner there with Eric Banner. He's a great talent, and best wishes for that one.
Thank you.
Anything else happening with Sony Pictures?
Oh, we're going to do a bit of a giveaway.
Oh, okay. We've got 5 double passes to 22 Jump Street to give away. All you have to do is SMS us the word movies. There it is on screen now. Movies, and put your name and address, please, and send it to 0439 929 929. The word movies, 0439 929 929. And please put your name and address as well. Thank you very much to Kathy Sharp. As
thank
always,
you.
A pleasure to have you
love
on board.
To be here.
And well done, and thank you. And don't forget the Sunflower Dash coming up in June as well. Check out the website for more details. We'll be back with more of The Couch right after this. Well done.
This episode of The Couch is proudly supported by Cafe Bella Vista Restaurant and Pizzeria. Azito, give it a go with Azito. Refresh Pure Water. And Reading Cinemas, experience the difference.
Welcome back to The Couch here at Aurora Television around Australia. Dennis Law is back, and he's got a fantastic segment today. It's called Breaking Through Success. Here's Neesha.
Thank you, Fred. Yes, Dennis, a master change consultant, is with us today on The Couch. Welcome along.
Thank you, Neesha. Nice to see you. Nice to be here.
Thank you. Now, being a master change consultant, recently you've had some really great success helping people who might be going through a difficult time, particularly with post-traumatic stress disorder. Can you talk us through your approach when this particular gentleman came to see you?
I will. This fellow, when he came to see me, really started off the conversation. He didn't know why he was there. Didn't know what to talk about. All we knew was he's very, very sad and very, very emotional about whatever had occurred. As he opened up his conversation, we realised that he would benefit from timeline therapy. Mm-hmm. Timeline therapy is very simply going back in time, mm-hmm. along your timeline, to the very beginning where the first event ever occurred. Mm. Once you get to that point in time, very simply look back on it from up above in your timeline until you emotionally disconnect from that event. Mm. Once you've done that, you can then come back to today, stopping off at any events in the timeline until you've disconnected from them.
What's the significance of that emotional disconnect?
If you don't disconnect from the emotion, it will always be there. So a trigger will then trigger off that negative emotion and make you feel exceptionally angry, exceptionally sad, fearful, any of those things which are negative emotions that we don't want. Whenever you look back on any event in the past, you must disconnect from the emotion of it to be able to go forward from today. And that leads me into the discussion about breaking through. Breaking through the barriers of negative emotions, negative feelings, so you have positive energy going forward. Now, what we'd like to introduce for our next session is breaking through to success. And in doing that...
Mm-hmm. I can see you've got a prop there.
We're going to break through this board with a tiny little hand on the television in front of everyone so they can see what a breakthrough actually looks like.
Wow, okay. So, and that'll be on our next segment.
On the next segment, yep.
But I'd like to go back because I know, being a psychologist, I know that a lot of people try different approaches when they've got an issue in their life. Yep. So PTSD, post-traumatic stress disorder, we just spoke about, depression, anxiety. Have you helped people with depression as well?
Oh, I did, very recently, and that was just last week. Mm-hmm. A lady came to me, she'd been to various people, medical practitioners, psychiatrists, psychologists, and she just could not get rid of the depression at all. We took her back on a timeline and talked to her unconscious mind to find out what that negative emotion was. I found it, fixed it, and she has improved like I've never seen anything like it in my life. Very, very rewarding, not only for me, but obviously for the person concerned, and that they're not going around with the symptoms of depression anymore.
And how did she find you? Did she come?
She came and spoke to me.
Okay.
Yeah, just last week. And in doing so, it was a very great step forward for her. She's found something that she's totally delighted with and a great leap forward for her. She broke through.
That's fantastic to hear. Because, you know, in any point in time in our lives, people do, I think it's 1 in 3 is the stat, will experience a mental health issue. And it's, personally, I think it's either degree or function. At the end of the day, the stigma needs to go down.
Yep.
So what other, I guess, reasons would people come and seek out your assistance?
People would come, obviously, to get rid of any baggage they've got from the past that they don't want to be lugging around with them. But they also come to find out their inner strength to achieve the best they can be. Okay. That whatever they want and set goals for the future, they want to do that, they can break through to their own success, which is why we started talking about that.
So it's really a case where people can optimize their experience.
Absolutely,
life.
Yeah. Greater optimize their life experience and go forward with a lot of happiness that they might not have had been able to experience previously.
Oh, that's wonderful. I like that
it
positive
is.
Psychology spin.
It is. It's nice, isn't it?
It's great. Now, if people want to find out more, where do they go?
They go to my website, www.protechenergy2014.com.
Fantastic. And, of course, information is always available on thecouch.com.au. Next week, we are certainly looking forward to this exercise. There is a lot to talk about with the work that you do, but I think it's wonderful that you help people. We have to take that holistic approach.
I think that's the side that I like the most. It's very, very rewarding for me, inside, but to see people going off being the best they can be, that's a fantastic thing to see.
Oh, that's lovely to hear.
It is lovely.
It's really good. Well, we'll look forward to talking to you on the couch
next week.
Thank you. Okay, so that website one more time, thecouch.com.au, and it's back to you now, Fred.
Wow, Neesha, you really broke through that segment very, very well. What a success. And we'll have that little skit, I suppose we'll call it, in the next couple of weeks as well. Thanks very much for being on the show. Time for us to say goodbye. Don't forget that Alix Jordan is trying to put together an Olivia Newton-John tribute show. Please go to her website. It's on screen at the end of the show on the actual music act. Thank you for watching today, New Zealand. Thank you, Australia. Thanks to you on the web that's watching the show as well. We're going to leave you today with another Olivia Newton-John song. It's called Let It Shine. Until next time we meet, bye for now. Bow, 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 bow. Woman needs attention like the flowers need the sun. Without that attention, will a woman feel so numb? Now I'm like a flower that's been standing in the rain, hoping and praying that the sun will shine again. Is there anybody out there who can shine? Anytime would be fine. Is there anybody out there who can blow? And who would like to see a little flower grow? Shine on me.
Shine on me, let it shine.
Yeah.
Bow, 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 bow. Bow, bow, bow. Bow, 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 bow.
Woman needs a love light to keep her body warm. Know that that love light, well, her mind can do her harm. Now that light's gone out for me, I'm standing in the dark, hoping and praying just to see your little spark. Is there anybody out there who can shine? Anytime would be fine. Is there anybody out there who can glow? Shine on me,
let it shine.
Is there anybody out there who can shine?
Anybody who can shine.
Will be fine.
Anybody will
be fine. Is there anybody out there who can glow?
Anybody
and
who
would like to see this woman's love light shine?
Shine a little light.
Shine on me.
Shine on me, let it shine.
Yeah. Bow, 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 bow. Bow, bow, bow. Bow, 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 bow. Yeah.
This episode of The Couch is proudly supported by Cafe Bella Vista Restaurant and Pizzeria. Azito, give it a go with Azito. Refresh Pure Water. And Reading Cinemas, experience the difference.